said, don't worry, everything will just be fine. So just sign your name right here, sir, on this dotted line. Pretty soon the water was tasting pretty dire. One day I lit a match and the water caught on fire. I thought about a lawsuit, then stumbled upon the fact that fracking is exempted from the Clean Water Act. No fracking way, no fracking way. Democracy works here in the USA. No fracking way, no fracking way, no fracking way. As if the situation weren't sufficiently unattractive, we tested the water and found it was radioactive. Now my property is worthless and there's a tumor in my brain. Half of my neighbors are sick, the rest are just in pain. Maybe I should take the money, move off, live somewhere, but all the places I look at, they're fracking there. Our choices now are simple: lose that which we hold dear, or communicate the message in a way that's unstoppably clear. No fracking way, no fracking way. Tell these frackers to frack off, tomorrow and today. No fracking way, no fracking way, no fracking way, no fracking way. There was on the 40th anniversary, I believe it was, 10 years before last October, there were people who were on all sides of the missile crisis, Cubans, Americans, and Russians, had a conference in Cuba. They found out a lot of things that were not previously known at that conference, including the fact that we very nearly, and very specifically, in one specific instance, we very nearly saw the extinction of our species. And but for the actions of one man, we'd all be dead. And so I wrote a song about it. The Beach Boys were playing on the radio. The Beatles were singing Love Me Do. Lolita was playing in the cinemas in October 1962. Ken Kesey published One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. John Lennon orbited the Earth. Australia had just won the most gold medals in the Commonwealth Games in Perth. The Boomers were just getting into high school. Dylan first sang Blowing in the Wind. The U.S. Army had recently started their war against the Vietnam. On the day Basil saved the world. If I Had a Hammer was in the Billboard charts, the Air Force jet crashed into the sea. The first black student had been admitted to Ole Miss University. Hewlett-Packard sold a personal computer, but it wouldn't really take off for a while. Jackie had just come back from a trip to India. Plunging necklines were the latest summer style. Algeria had just won their independence. Korea was rebuilding from the war. The Russian River had just flooded a couple of weeks before. On the day Vasily saved the world.
Russian mongers, killing Cubans in their factories and streets. The U.S. was making plans for an invasion, still smarting from the Bay of Pigs' defeat. The Soviets had sent missiles to Havana to protect themselves and their Cuban friends. Then the U.S. Navy blockaded Cuba's harbors, and there was no telling how this thing would end. Khrushchev got on TV and made it very clear, Cuba is a sovereign state, and if our ships are attacked, we will retaliate. On the day, Vasily saved the world. Vice Admiral Vasily Arkhipov was standing at his post on a Soviet Navy submarine. They were on patrol in international waters, one actor in a terrifying scene. They were out of radio contact, deep beneath the water, when the sub began to shake and crack. The captain said, "Arm the nuclear torpedoes. We're under attack." The Americans were bombing them, but in order to respond, three officers had to give the go. Two were in agreement, but for some reason, the vice admiral said no. On the day, a servant saved the world.
April 25th, 2013, here in Dallas, and we're planning a big event. We have a Facebook page, website coming out soon. We expect all of you to be there because, you know, we really can't let this go on without some, you know, the reinvention of this administration as something legitimate can't go on without some kind of objection to it, lest it be continued forever and ever. So anyway, I was just wondering if you had some kind of song about that would relate to that,
let me do that.
Kind of pump us all up for getting accountability, so that
from this federal government.
Or, yes.
Yeah. What kind
yes.
of, yeah.
That and
from
our
that government.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Push. Yeah. Our favorite side.
Our favorite side.
All right. Talk about Texas.
About what? 6 miles.
About George.
Texas.
Oh, okay.
George. Old George Tuner.
George.
Pass the hat for the tar sands, and I'll do two more songs. How about
right.
that? And, oh yeah, the light. Somebody leaving it. So, and I've seen these over there, and my landlord and my dentist are really getting down on me. We need some CD purchases, or otherwise I'm gonna have to get a job. And let's see, I'll do this one, which is about, I guess, yeah. How's it go?
the working class and you would march on our picket lines. You'd say you're with the underdogs, not the billionaires of Wall Street. And you look so earnest as you shake the hands of all the good people you meet, but you don't fool me. You can talk so convincingly about all the hazards we face. You can blather on about green jobs with nukes and natural gas. You can reminisce about your youth and the time that you smoked some grass, but you don't fool me. No, you don't fool me. You can say you are a man of peace. You can talk like you know the score. Yeah, if you were in the Senate at the time, you would have voted against the war. Green drone strikes a blow for liberty. You can claim this is not an empire. You just want everyone to be free, but you don't fool me. No, you don't fool me. Say, give us 4 more years. You can make the case your party is so different from the other. You can say you've got my back. You can call yourself my brother, but you don't fool me. No, you don't fool me. You don't fool me. No, you don't fool me.
March 2003, the war has been called Operation Iraqi Freedom. They used to change the names of their campaigns to make them seem like they were new, you know, but I guess they couldn't do that because they were still there the whole time. So they called it Operation Iraqi Freedom, which, as you know, of course, in English, the acronym is OIF, which is not a word. But for several hours, it actually had a different name. And this is the brilliance of George W. Bush and his entire administration. This is why I miss Bush so much. Because of his complete lack of eloquence. You know, that was really a very attractive characteristic for a left-wing songwriter. You want your politicians inarticulate. You want them to just constantly put their feet in their mouth because it's much easier to write a song about them that way. But when they're all, like, you know, articulate and sound progressive, this is not helpful. You want your wolves in wolf clothing, not in sheep's clothing. It's easier. But the best wolves, the most successful wolves, dress like sheep. So you're going to have to deal with that. You being all of us. We've got a situation and it calls for a solution that upholds our domination of the planet. We're gonna make our case and we're gonna
just look into the camera and lie. It's operation Iraqi liberation. Tell me, what does that spell for? Operation Iraqi liberation. O-I-L. It's good to sing along, and it's good for cheerleader moves as well. We'll lie about the missiles and the nuclear research. We'll lie about uranium. We'll build military bases and smile for reporters as we give away bubble gum. We'll lie about Bin Laden, his connections with the Saudis. We'll lie about 9-1-1. We'll lie about the Baptists, their connections to Al-Qaeda, because we know there's none. Operation Iraqi liberation. Tell me, what does that spell? Operation Iraqi liberation. O-I-L.
There we go.
We'll lie about the North Koreans and we'll lie about Iran. And don't mention Israel. Keep those nuclear weapons out of this song. And we'll all get together. Swell. And we'll liberate these people, we'll liberate their money, we'll liberate their soil, we'll liberate their airports, we'll liberate their harbors, and we'll liberate their oil. It's Operation Iraqi Liberation. Tell me, what does that spell? Operation Iraqi Liberation.
Governors oppose it, and every native band. Ranchers don't want it
passing through their land. Union leaders have denounced it, as have the rank and file. The president delayed it for just a little while. They say you can't stop progress. I hope that isn't true. Cause if we mine the tar sands, if we let the pipeline through, it will be a pipeline to oblivion. A pipeline to the end. A pipeline to a future with nothing round the bend. A pipeline to a future that I hope we'll never know. Pipeline from the tar sands to the Gulf of Mexico. A pipeline from the tar sands to the Gulf of Mexico. A pipeline from the tar sands to the Gulf of Mexico.
Talk with David and talk with each other. I do want everyone to go on our Facebook page and sign up for the